Josh Todd from Buckcherry, obviously.
What's up?
Last time you were here, you were actually playing for Lazer Fest in front of 15,000 people, which you may be used to, but that was actually record-breaking for the radio station.
Oh, wow, so. Cool. Yeah, that was a... I remember that show. Sure.
You do remember it.
Yeah.
All right. It was good times. And it was at the end of May, so it wasn't too long ago. So good to have you back here in Des Moines.
It's good to be back. Yeah.
Always a good time. And you've kind of been touring since then, I think. Did you get any sort of break at all in between?
We just had 3 weeks off, which is really nice.
That is nice.
We really needed it. We've been working really hard. We've been basically on the road since Crew Fest last summer. So, you know, it's good to be home with our families, decompress a little bit.
Right, that 3 weeks is probably feels like 2 months when it's, I mean, it's only...
yeah, we can... You're a father
of three kids, right?
I have three kids, yeah, so that's all I do when I'm home.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Do you ever get kind of, being on the road that long, does it ever get to a day where you're just like, God, I just really want to get my ass home and see my kids? Like, what keeps you going when you are feeling that way?
Well, my kids are really motivating because they're a lot of responsibility, so that motivates me to do what I got to do out here, you know. But I try to get home every 10 days.
That's nice.
For like a day and a half, I'll fly in and then fly back out. I'm in the air a lot, you know, getting back and forth, but, you know, I'm dedicated that way. And then sometimes I get them out with me, you know. When they get a little bigger.
They probably love that. How old are they?
I have one that's 15, 3, and 7 months. 8 months.
That is quite the age difference there. How's the 15-year-old like it?
She's awesome, but she's in school right now, so.
Okay. And I actually just heard that you guys will be going out on tour with Kiss. That is huge.
Yeah, that starts September 25th and in Detroit, Rock City. We're really excited. And, you know, we got to tour with them on our first record, so it's going to be a nice rock and roll.
They've been together, this like tour. 35 years that they've been touring?
35 years, and we've been touring a decade, so it's, you know, it's going to be great, and we have a lot of fun together, so I think the show's going to come off nice.
So you guys have already toured with them. How did that come about? Did they give you a call?
Well, they didn't just call us. They called our manager, and, you know, they Kiss likes us because we're, you know, we stuck to our guns, and we're straight up rock and roll band after all this time, and they respect that, and that's why they wanted us back, and appreciate that, you know, a lot, because we're huge fans.
I actually had the opportunity to ask some fans what they would ask you if they had the chance, and it was funny, because this is not bad, I promise. Everybody kind of had the same response, which was surprising. They wanted to know about your tattoos, actually.
Right.
You get that probably all the time. But they kind of wanted to know if there's one in particular that that really means a lot to you. Obviously, I'm a huge tattoo fan, too. So when you put something on your body, it means a lot to you anyways. But is there one in particular?
I got my throat tattooed, which is something I wanted to do for a long time, but I was putting it off because of the pain. And it's just my son's name, Jack. And then I have this kanji that says King, basically. It says King Jack, my son. You know?
And your knuckles, actually, our night DJ noticed. Is that a reference to The Outsiders?
Yes.
All right.
Stay
rest
gold.
In peace, Patrick Swayze.
Yeah,
unfortunately.
It's a drag.
I know. The Outsiders is one of those movies that I think everybody passes up. It's not really...
It's a great
movie. Everybody's like, Roadhouse, this and that, but...
It's a classic, timeless film, and it's a great book as well, you know, written by a woman.
Oh, yeah. We're powerful sometimes, you know? Come on, Josh.
Very powerful.
See? I'm Mysterious. Powerful. I'm a powerful human being, aren't I?
For sure. Yes. I have great respect.
And, actually, you guys just did re-release the album. Does it have anything extra on there?
Yes, it's the enhanced version for her pleasure. It's actually got NASCAR. We did a theme song for NASCAR, which is actually a Deep Purple track called Highway Star. And we just don't do a lot of cover songs, so we got a lot of overwhelming response from the song, you know. And so we just decided to re-release the record, bring some more attention to Black Butterfly because we're just so proud of it, and give somebody, you know, a little extra bang for their buck, you know. And people are really happy with it.
Also, I heard that you guys might be working on a live album. Is that true? You got a live one coming out?
We finished the live record. It comes out September 29th. And,
September 29th, that live album will be in stores.
Yes, okay. Live and Loud 2009. Or Loud and Live, one of them.
And I got to bust you a little bit about this, because I know I'm not going to get anything out of you, but do you have a secret, something secret project going on? That's what the internet's saying.
A secret project
going on?
No, I mean we're working on a new record for next year, and it's gonna be kind of off the beaten path for us, and that's all I'll say about it. But people are gonna dig it.
Cool, absolutely. Well, thank you so much for your time.
All right,
it's been
cool.
Nice meeting you.
Nice meeting you.